Hello everyone. Now for those of you who have seen my other YouTube videos on my channel, you might recognise a maroon coloured 1980s Raleigh Courier. I got the bike about a year and 3 months ago, no 2 years and 3 months ago now, 2017, and about a week after I got it, gave it a quick refurb and did a riding video. Not very good, my usual handheld phone stuff. Talked you through the bike. I discussed then the unlikelihood that I would sell it, purely because the money I had in it was as much as what it was worth. So what I did when I built up the collection a little bit more, got a few more, I decided to use the Courier as a test bed. So that's what I did. It's been testing ideas before I put them onto other bikes, or just, oh, I wonder if that would work or whatever. So that's what I've done. This has become my test mule, if you like. And there's not much left of it now, apart from the frame and forks. Raleigh aficionados might say, oh, look, it's got the Raleigh bottom bracket. Yes, but if you look back at that early video, it didn't have this bottom bracket. This bike dates from after they deleted the herons. I fitted a heron chain set because I wanted one, just for the looks, before I started modifying everything else, really. So, in fact, everything has been changed, modified, fitted with lighter modern components, except for the bottom bracket. And as it happens, it's beginning to develop a bit of a click. So the next thing I'm going to do is fit a square taper bottom bracket with some Raleigh cranks from one of the late Superb models, which is an alloy crank with Raleigh decal, and it's quite nice TA lookalike basically. So let's go through the bike and I'll show you what I've done to it. The stem did not need changing. These SR alloy topped stems were standard in this model of bike, so I've left that. The handlebars though, although they look like a North Road pattern, they're actually Humpert Stuttgarter. They come in different widths and materials. I've got them on three different bikes, and very, very nice bikes. They're marked as Ergotech because Stuttgart are one of those OEM type manufacturers. Headlamp. It didn't come with lights, this bike, although it would have done originally. The headlamp is another modern one by Bushell. It's an LED, of course, with the reflector ring, a bit like a Busch & Müller, but slightly smaller. Similar size to the Raleigh Sports type of headlamp. Moving down, we've got alloy rim. These Tiger tyres, you get them off eBay quite cheaply if you look for Amberwall tyres, and they're pretty good. They're more or less a World Tour copy, and I would recommend them. And that's a Sturmey Archer XFDD. So it's a drum brake with dynamo. I love these, I've got them on a few bikes, and that powers just the front light on this bike. I haven't wired it through to the back. I thought I'd keep it tidy. And there's the drum brake side. All conventional stuff. Even the mudguard stays have been upgraded with Dutch ones. And apart from the two, replaced a bit of bent wire that was there originally. The Greyhound mascot, that's from a German Express Fahrrad. That was gifted to me a few years ago by a German cycling friend. I don't know if he wants me to name him, so I won't, but thank you very much, you know who you are. And then these, for some reason, never had pump clips on, so I've added that pump clip, and I use a one-ended pump that just locates into the bottom. The strap is just on there for a bit of extra protection. And the decals, I think these were meant to be on a Lenten Sports. It's just an old pair that I had in the back of the shop. Ditto the Clarion and Sturmey Archer stickers on here. They're just there for adornment, really. Dutch coat guards, skirt guards, dress guards, whatever you want to call them. As you can probably see, if you look at the curve, this one was made for a 700C, but it's fine on here. It's what the very late Superbs had on them. the standard Raleigh rack. No reason to change it, really functional piece of kit. A little bit awkward that it fastens onto the hub, onto the axles. Stainless steel wheel nuts made by Dyno Hub Matt about 12 years ago now for me, and that is an XRD3. This is another one of the modern Sturmey Archers. That stands for rear drum 3-speed, and I've got mixed feelings about this. I like the smoothness of the gear change, I like the silence, although I miss the character of the tick tick tick. However, I have two of these hubs. One that I have on a Gazelle collapsed on me last week, and I mean it really ate itself from the inside out. It's a right mess, the planets are stripped, the bearings are collapsed, everything. That was from 2012. This one is from 2013. Not long ago it lost first gear, so I took the innards out and basically it was just a brown mess inside. It's the sealed for life greased gears, and basically I prefer the old oil ones, but that's the modern age. People don't want to have to put a teaspoonful of oil in every year, so they've gone grease, and they're not proving to be as durable as the originals. Rear light is a Pixio by Spanninger, just a nice little LED light. And the white tail is just an affectation, a rather messy white tail. And a nice vintage pannier I've got on it here, obviously, accessory. I've got a set of five of these bags, which I used to run on randonneur bikes. I haven't really got a randonneur bike at the moment. Apart from a motorbike waiting to be built up, and the tandem that never gets used. And the pedals, nice functional BMX pedals. They look a bit odd on the steel cranks, but of course that will soon change. Original kickstand. These late frames, as I've said on other videos, I like them because they have a plate for the kickstand, they have a plate for the rack. Oh yes, there's a lock on here, a Dutch lock as well, which is a very handy parking brake. You just click them on when you're parked in situations like this and the bike won't roll away. Cable guides on the top tube as well, I like that on these frames. Again, some different models vary in their brazons. This has what it has. And the alloy rims, I can't even remember whose alloy rims they are, they're just a fairly generic thing. So we have a robust, reliable, comfortable, stylish looking knockabout bike. I wouldn't leave it in certain places, but for general purpose, if you're parking at work, parking at home, that's fine, as long as you can keep an eye on the bike. I think we're just about caught up with the modifications, apart from the 22-tooth sprocket, which is a standard of mine, to lower the gearing, and as you can probably see, it's got a shiny chain. That's a Whipperman silver chain that's on there. They're absolutely brilliant. And so now I think it's time for a little ride around the park. The maroon shoes are just pure coincidence. I only dress to match my bike when I'm doing things like tweed rides, he says. Oh gosh, I need to replace the shifter on this bike as well. That shifter's toast really. It works, but it's horrible. This is Stanley Park, Blackpool, one of the best parks in the country. In fact, it was voted Britain's best park a couple of years ago. Not sure I'd go that far myself, but you know, well done to them. Very well done to them. Beautiful park. Art Deco Cafe, completely restored. Crowded down that end for these purposes. Shouldn't really cycle through this bit. This is the sensory garden. So I'm just going to be very slow and careful and give way to these people. Indeed, the lake. He spotted it. That's where we're going. It is an active bandstand. They have bands on every Sunday of all descriptions. And it's celebrating its 90th anniversary this year. This video is getting a bit long, so I'm going to cut off now. I might make a separate video riding through the park, just because it's nice and quiet.